Now I'm going to show how to do the herringbone rib with lace. And let me zoom in a little bit on the needles so you could see how they are set up. And what I did was I will start on the ribber and I will pull three needles up. And actually you probably want to start right at the center and work out and then work the other way. But what it is you have three needles up to work, two non-working, three working, two non-working, three working, two non-working. Now over here I went 3 and 1 to show you, and I missed one there, that should be up. So I'm going to have to grab that needle, that stitch, to be on there. But 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1. Because this is a sample, I'm not going to worry too much about this. Where if it was something I was working on, I would take and redo this over. But what you do is you cast on your zigzag cast on. Then you hang your ribber comb, your barrel weights. And then you put your carriages, you push in your left partial on the knitter and you put your right cam lever up to partial. This is set to star and the tension dial in the knitter is to 0. You knit the 3 rows of selvage and then you put everything back to plain. Now, I did forget to mention that you should have the outside needle up here on the knitter just for the selvage. And what you need to do at the end of the 3 selvage rows is to take this end stitch, if it will allow me, and put it down on the ribber end needle. Normally, you need the end stitch up on the knitter, but I found that you don't necessarily have to. Just be a little careful is all. You do start out with your racking indicator on H3, and we're going to be moving that back and forth to create this herringbone. Now to set up the carriages. I'm going to take my tension dial on the knitter and put it to 2. You put it to whatever yarn you're using. And then I'm going to push in my left tuck button. On the ribber, you're going to put the tension dial also to 2, or according to the yarn you're using. You're going to put your tucking lever over to P, and you're going to take your right cam button and put it up to PR. And this is a combination of 12 rows, so you probably want to reset your counter and have your tripper down so that it's going to do your counting for you. You start out with your racking indicator still on H3. You knit 1 row. Now you're going to put the racking indicator to H4 and knit 1 row. And now you go back to H3 and knit 1 row. And again, back to H4, knit 1 row. And you keep doing this until you get 12 rows on the counter. I'm going to readjust the camera so you can get a different view of this. Again, I put my racking indicator to H3 to go from right to left. Works easier when I have both hands on. And when I go from left to right, I have it on H4. Well, maybe I do have a little bit of lint someplace there. H3. H4. Now there's my row 12. Now I'm going to reverse this row 12, the next 12 rows. And when you work from right to left, you're now going to have it in H4 and from left to right, H3. I'm seeing a few of my stitches are not knitting here. And there's row 24. So now I go back to the first 12 rows, where from right to left is on H3 and from left to right is on H4. And you continue doing this for as long as you need it. So I'm going to do up another set, take it off the machine, and show you what it looks like in the end. And here it is. As you could see on the left where I had the two needles out of work, it makes a wider lace, and over here on the right, where I only had one needle out of work, it's a smaller lace. But it's up to you which way you want to do this. I don't know if you can go more than two needles. You could try it. It's all a matter of trial and error anyways to get what you want going on this. And this would make a really lovely scarf. Of course, you could probably put it on a pillow cover. If you want to put it onto a sweater, that's up to you also. But I'm sure you'll find things to make with this design.